Good day to you. Today I am reviewing The Cross and the Switchblade by David Wilkerson. Now, first off, this is not for kids. It is a very good book. It is a very powerful book. But there will be some subject matter that will be not appropriate for elementary age kids, including prostitution and just things of that nature. The reading level, though, is about a fifth or sixth grade level, as far as, so that of course, I'm referring to the difficulty level, right? So it's a high school book, but it's an easier than other high school. It's much easier than Dostoevsky. Okay. The premise of the book, the plot of the book, it's actually a true story about a Pentecostal preacher who tells this great story about how one day he was reading in the news, and he reads this story about these three young hoodlum kids, three young street kids, these kind of gang kids from in the 1950s, who were on trial for murder. And he suddenly feels that God is calling him to go and try to talk to these guys. And he shows up at their trial and makes a big scene on accident, and ends up getting himself arrested as well. And the great irony of this is he never actually meets these kids. The very reason the whole story starts was to meet these kids, and he actually never gets to do that because he's never allowed to meet them. But through this begins, he starts a street ministry of where he brings Jesus to drug addicts and gang members. And it's a hardcore book. I mean, it's this is not West Side Story. It's although it's, the same time period and about the same, the same subject matter, gangs. It's not a cleaned up version of gang violence and 50s and 60s, I should say, by the way. So he's dealing with murderers, with drug addicts, with rapists, there are scenes where he's invited one time to go and actually sit with people as they shoot up heroin, because he says, I want to see what you guys do. And these people, and so he watches them shoot up heroin. And one of his ministries is actually getting people off their addiction, where these people agree and they sign a contract. They say, where he says, all right, if you agree, then I'm going to put you in a room, I'm going to lock you up, and you're going to go cold turkey. You're not going to have any access to drugs, and we're gonna keep you here for days, weeks, however long it takes. And it's a tense book where these people are freaking out. They're screaming, they're crying, and they're saying, please let me out. But he knows ahead of time, they've already agreed that he won't let him out. And all the hard things they have to do just to get off heroin and drugs. It's a great book. It's a very powerful book. I would recommend it to any teenager who thinks they can handle it, or adult. Some notes about David Wilkerson: he is a Pentecostal, so although it doesn't show up in the book, just to be aware that he has sometimes said some things that are fairly anti-Catholic. There are some writings of his where he kind of hints that he thinks the Pope and the Church are the Whore of Babylon. And everybody knows that's not true. It's actually David Hasselhoff, and I can prove it. But other than that, he seems to have been a good guy with good intentions. I think he passed away, so I should talk about him in the past tense. But like I said, though, that doesn't show up in the book. So if you start looking at his other stuff, be aware of that. And I don't think it should at all discredit his story, and it is a very inspiring book, and about how the power of God and the love of Jesus can change people, and how just one person through the Holy Spirit, being moved by the Spirit and just listening to the Holy Spirit, can make these huge changes in all these people's lives. He's this country bumpkin preacher from, I think it was upstate New York, who ends up just moving to New York City into the ghetto, and ends up changing people's lives and starting this ministry. and that still exists. So The Cross and the Switchblade, very good book. Bottom line is, not for kids, and some salacious material, but nothing. It's not presented in a salacious way, so maybe I shouldn't call it salacious material. I should say adult material. All right, hope you enjoy it. I do recommend it. Enjoy.